الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
One, two.
Shaykh Wadda, come forward, please. One, two. Try one more. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Right, sorry about that. What a start to the first Juma Salah on this blessed month of Ramadan. We're sorry about the sound system. Something has gone wrong. We'll try and fix it, inshallah. Today is the fifth Ramadan. We are going to bid farewell to. So jazakumullah khair, barakallah feekum for all your beautiful donations throughout the months. And I hope you continue to give sadaqah. We are feeding a lot of people in the iftar time. So if anyone would like to sponsor an iftar, please come forward. It's £500. It's actually cost us about £1,000 a night, but we'll get two people to sponsor it. So if you want to do it, it's a £500. Or £5 per person. So that's the appeal. Now today I have made a target that we want to raise around about £10,000. And I'll tell you why very quickly. If the sound system didn't go a little bit haywire, we would have done that. As you know, we want to buy the building, which is the Rimas Music Building, right next to the original masjid. This building, the Rimas Music, was part of the Abdullah Kulliya Masjid way back in 1889, 135 years ago. So we want to get that building back. It's in the market. It's not in the market. We're buying it privately. It's a private seller. The building is worth £500,000, but original price is about 800,000. And I've had a letter from the sellers that they're giving us a week to exchange the contract. And we need to put a hefty deposit on it as well. So brothers and sisters, what I'm looking for, we get about 2,500 people in this masjid. If 2,000 people gave £200, that's your £400,000. So I'm going to ask, can you give a loan to the masjid to purchase that building before the end of Ramadan? That will be the completion date. So do we have any kind brothers who can actually say, I'm going to give £2,000 as a loan, 5,000, 1,000, 500, whatever you can. Can I get a show of hand very quickly and then I'll stop? Inshallah. Anyone would like to say, I'll raise £5,000 or £2,000 within my family? Anyone? So the target today is 500. Takbir, Allahu Akbar, as a loan, as a donation, mashallah. Sheikh, what they learned to write that down? Father Ramzi started. So that is still recorded. Thank you. Anyone else, please, very quickly. 500, donation or a loan? How much is donation? Okay, Brother Shabuz, Father Ramzi, how much, brother? 500, can I take your name? Brother Sawar. Any other brothers, quickly? Anyone want to give a loan of 1,000, 2,000 or 5,000? Remember, giving the loan to the masjid, you get the same ajr as you have donated. Am I right in that, Sheikh Sadiq? Sheikh Harun? Yes, so when you give a loan, Kharz-e Hasana, to the house of Allah, the time that he stays in the masjid because you helped us to buy the building, you get the same ajr as though you have donated. That's what I had from last time. Correct. I am right. I've been just cleared by Sheikh Harun. Jazakallah khair. I don't say anything until I clear it from these scholars, because I'm not a scholar. Right. Come on. Let's see. Another few more £500. You can pay by the end of Ramadan. It's not a problem. Any other brothers? We've only got 1,500. Come on, brothers. You don't have to pay now. Any brothers? How about Kharz-e Hasana? 5,000, 1,000, 2,000. Who would like to go? If the brothers are listening on the other side of the room, please give us your list. And if the sisters are listening to me, please give us a list as well. Oh, Kharz-e Hasana is an interest-free loan where we will pay you back without any interest. No paying, no riba. We will not give you any riba. You just whatever the money you let us, you borrow us, you give it to us, we will pay you back in the time that we agree with you. Another 500, you got the name? Yusuf, brother Yusuf? MashaAllah. Takbir! What's your name, brother? Rob, £1,000. That's a donation or a... MashaAllah. Takbir! Rob and Shiraz. Yeah? Now, I'm just taking the name. Please contact me. Or you can go directly to the bank, transfer into the bank, which is much better, and let me know you have done it. So I've got the list. Inshallah. Where's our money collector gone? Oh, it's gone to the back. Okay. Any other brothers? That's really good. We've gone to £2,000 now. Any other brothers, please? Okay. Very quickly, why are we buying this building? Number one, because it was part of the original masjid where people said Allahu Akbar. That's number one. Number two, look at this building. This is the biggest room. How many of us here? About 170? Look at the room behind. Look at the room in the front. It's all box room in this building, mashallah. What do we want? A people, 2,000 people praying in one hall, like you have in Al-Rahma, big, big hall in one go. They can see the imam. So that's what we're trying to create. We're going to have a dedicated space for sisters with a separate access. We're going to have the funeral specialist in a special funeral facilities there. It's very difficult to do janazah here because not everybody's together. And this building will be used for the madrasa, for the teachings. And this whole building, we've got loads of classroom. It will be held to employability, to educate people, to have madrasa, to have gym, health center, well, women's center. Everything that really touches our lives, that will be your spiritual building, inshallah. So please, I don't want to talk, I want to raise the money. Who else would like to say £5,000 as a kharde hasana? Then I'll stop. I need to get to £10,000. I'm really delaying Sheikh Harun on the khutbah and I shouldn't be. Inshallah, can I leave it with that? That everybody that is listening to me, can everybody make a promise that you will pay £200? Is that a promise during the month of Ramadan? I'm not asking you to get today. If you can, those who are really unable, I agree. Those who are working, professionals, doctors, barristers, businessmen, you need to give us £2,000 as a loan and at least pay £1,000 as a donation. Inshallah, I'll carry on tonight. I've got to raise that money to be able to secure the building. We cannot let go of that building. It's so important for our younger generations. Brothers and sisters, one final word. If we lose that building, Rima's Music today, you will never get it back in your lifetime. This is once in a lifetime. We have the building, we build the masjid that Abdullah Kulliam, you'll see on the reception, he actually saw, he had a vision to build the masjid here. He never got the time to do it. You have. Whenever you build a masjid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala builds a palace for you in Jannah. Think about it. I'm going to go, you're going to go in a three-piece of cloth, shrouded. Does that cloth coffin has pockets that you can take your money with you, wealth with you? No. It's got no pocket. So you're going by yourself with nothing. What do you take? As Sheikh say, you take the sadaqatul jariyah that you give, the charity that you give while you are still alive. So think about it. And building the masjid is the biggest of all. Because thousands of people will pray for thousands of years to come. Abdullah Kulliam is getting the barakah, is getting the ajr after 106 years. And he'll carry on getting it from all of us until, for a very long time. Inshallah, jazakumullah khair. If those who want to pay for the iftar, please do come forward. We do have Turkish chefs who are actually cooking for us tonight. Bring your families. Tomorrow we have the special two brothers. Two boys are coming to, we have an event, 4:30. You'll need to buy the ticket. And there are two convert brothers, Ben and Chris. Beautiful people, they're Muslims. and they will be doing a conference tomorrow at the food hall, so you need to buy a ticket for that. Also, on the 23rd, we have a grand iftar. If you need to go to our website and our Facebook, book your ticket for that as well. We have a grand iftar here in the masjid. Sister Najiba is doing a program tomorrow as well for the sisters. So please look into our programs and look into downstairs. There is a television with all the programs being listed. Jazakumullah khair for listening to me. Thank you for your time. Dr. Zafar Malik, Assalamu alaikum. Okay, I'll talk to him later. Jazakumullah khair. Sheikh Harun, over to you.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على
الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله الحمد لله المنعم المتفضل الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه وخليله خير نبي أرسله أرسله الله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا وداعيًا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجًا منيرًا فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه كلما ذكره الذاكرون وكلما غفل عن ذكره الغافلون أما بعد يقول الله عز وجل بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون فأوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله اتقوا الله في السر والعلن O believers, in this blessed month of Ramadan, the month about which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ وَكَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ شَهْرُ التَّقْوَى In this month about which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to us the obligation of fasting so that we must experience something of taqwa Allah, of the fear and awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, We remind ourselves and all that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O those who believe, have taqwa Allah as he truly deserves, fear Allah as he truly deserves, and only die as Muslims. So I give myself and all of you the advice and the counsel, ittaqullah, be fearful and conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times, at all places, whoever you are, wherever you are, whenever you are, ittaqullah, especially yawm al-jumu'ah, especially shahr Ramadan, especially sa'at al-khutbah, these blessed moments. It's a Friday, it's the month of Ramadan, it's the moment of the khutbah itself. These are the moments where sins are wiped out. The sins of a week, the sins of a year are all wiped out. Fattaqullaha ya ibadallah. We're in the month of Ramadan, the first Jum'ah of Ramadan, Shahrul Qur'an. Shahrul Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Qur'an. Hudan linnasi wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal-furqan. We're in the month of the Qur'an, the month of Ramadan in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed the Qur'an as a guidance for humanity, hudan linnas, wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal-furqan, and as a clarification of guidance and of the straight way. As we mentioned in preparation for the month of Ramadan, shahr al-siyam, the alamat al-qabool, the sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us something of Ramadan is our attachment to the Qur'an. We're blessed and honored that every night those who come here or whichever masjid, you listen to the Qur'an being recited. You yourself should be committed to reciting the Qur'an, because the fasting is not about the fasting, it's about the Qur'an. Yawm al-Qiyamah, on the Day of Judgment, as-siyam wal-Qur'an yashfa'an. Qur'an and fasting together will speak on behalf of that person. The fast will say, Ya Rabb, says, Oh my Lord, I made him starve during the day, so let me intercede for him. And the Qur'an will say, I made him go through sleepless nights, so let me speak on his behalf. The Qur'an and as-siyam, yashfa'an, they come together, they're inseparable. It's a month of fasting, it's a month of Qur'an. But today, we just want to look at something more in terms of our relationship with the Qur'an. Tilawat al-Qur'an is beautiful. Sama' al-Qur'an is beautiful. Reading and reciting the Qur'an and listening to the Qur'an is beautiful. But there's maqamat with the Qur'an. There's different levels and ranks that we need to reach with the Qur'an. الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ. Those who recite the book, they recite it as it truly deserves. Not just trying to make the Qur'an sound as beautiful as possible. That wasn't the point of the Qur'an. Not just to make yourself feel good or to impress somebody else. That's not the point of reading the Qur'an. حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. The Qur'an must unlock our hearts. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Do they not reflect over the Qur'an, or are there locks on their hearts? The Qur'an must unlock our hearts. It must open our hearts. Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, Jami' al-Qur'an. Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, radiallahu anhu arda, he would say, لَوْ طَهُرَتِ الْقُلُوبِ مَا شَبِعَتْ مِنْ كَلَامِ اللَّهِ. لَوْ طَهُرَتِ الْقُلُوبِ مَا شَبِعَتْ مِنْ كَلَامِ اللَّهِ. If hearts were pure, they would never get their fill of the Book of Allah. They will never come a point where they're satisfied with reading the Qur'an. مَقَامَاتْ مَعَ الْقُرْآنِ. There are levels with the Qur'an. المقام الأول كما قاله بعض العارفين من يشهد أوصاف المتكلم في كلامه. When you recite the Qur'an, you witness Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within the Qur'an. When you recite the Qur'an, you don't just think you're reading a book. You're doing more than reading a book. You're experiencing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within the Qur'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed himself through the Qur'an كما قال السيد الإمام جعفر الصادق رضي الله عنه وأرضاه لقد تجلى الله تعالى لخلقه بكلامه ولكن لا يبصرون. لقد تجلى الله تعالى لخلقه بكلامه ولكن لا يبصرون. Allah revealed himself to creation through his words, but they don't see. So the lowest level of حق تلاوته, of having a real experience with the Quran, وشهادة الله تعالى في كلام. That you witness and see أوصاف الخالق, the qualities of Allah سبحانه وتعالى within His words. المقام الثاني, من يشهد بقلبه كأنه تعالى يخاطبه ويناجيه. أن يشهد ومن يشهد بقلبه كأنه تعالى يناجيه ويخاطبه. The second level, moving to a higher state of حق تلاوته, experience with the Quran, is that in your heart you feel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to you. It's a conversation between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. المقام الثالث, من يرى أنه يناجي ربه. من يرى أنه يناجي ربه. The highest and the real maqam, the real relationship with the Quran, is that you see that you're having a private conversation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're talking, but in reality Allah's talking. And so when you read in the Quran, you don't see yourself. You don't see the voice that you're reading. You don't experience al-qari. It's all about al-mutakallim subhanahu wa ta'ala. And because of this, the real experience with the Quran is that you read in the Quran, but you hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the Quran. You hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as you read in the Quran. Al-Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, he gave an example of this. كان يقول Al-Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq رضي الله عنه أرضاه, عجبت لمن خاف كيف لا يفزع إلى قوله تعالى حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل فإني سمعت الله بعقبها يقول فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء. He said, I am surprised and amazed at a person who's in a state of worry and concern. He's in a state of fear. He doesn't rush to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. Allah is enough for, and He's the best of all who take care. Why? He said, إني سمعت الله يقول. He didn't say أنا قرأت. He didn't say أنا قرأت قول الله تعالى. إني سمعت الله يقول. He's not reading. He's hearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking to him. He said, because I heard Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying straight after, فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنْ هُمْ. They return back with the blessings of Allah and His virtue. لَمْ يَمْسَسْهُمْ سُوءٌ. And no difficulty touched them. The one who hears the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he's in a state of worry and fear, he reads حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ, because he'll be protected. وَعَجِبْتُ لِمَنْ اِغْتَمَّ. وَعَجِبْتُ لِمَنْ اِغْتَمَّ. Al-Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, he said, I'm amazed at somebody who's going through some stress and worry. كَيْفَ لَا يَفْزَعُ إِلَى قَوْلِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين فإني سمعت الله بعقبها يقول فاستجبنا له ونجيناه من الغم وكذلك ننجي المؤمنين. I'm amazed that somebody is going through worry and stress that he doesn't rush and read لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين, because سمعت الله, not أنا قرأت كلام الله, I heard Allah speaking, saying, we answered the noon, we answered Yunus alayhi salam, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ وَنَجَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمْ, and we saved him from his distress, and in the same way we'll save the believers, وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. So whenever you're in stress, listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's told you, if you read, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ, that He will save you from the stress that you're going through. وَعَجِبْتُ لِمَنْ مُكِرَ بِهِ. وَعَجِبْتُ لِمَنْ مُكِرَ بِهِ كَيْفَ لَا يَفْزَعُ إِلَى قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى وَأُفَوِّضُ أَمْرِي إِلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَصِيرٌ بِالْعِبَادِ فَإِنِّي سَمِعْتُ اللَّهَ يَقُولُ فَوَقَاهُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِ مَا مَكَرَ. I'm amazed at the one that people were being treacherous towards, betrayed them, stabbed them in the back. مُكِرَ بِهِ, how he does not come to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَأُفَوُّضُ أَمْرِي إِلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَصِيرٌ بِالْعِبَادِ. I leave all of my affair with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I leave it all to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He sees and watches over all of His slaves, because I heard Him say straight after, not I read, I heard Him straight after that, فَوَقَاهُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِ مَا مَكَرَ. Allah saved them from the evil of their treachery. وَعَجِبْتُ لِمَنْ طَلَبَ الدُّنْيَا وَزِينَتَهَا كَيْفَ لَا يَفْزَعُ إِلَى قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ فَإِنِّي سَمِعْتُ اللَّهَ يَقُولَ بِعَقِبِهَا إِنْ تَرَنِي أَنَا أَقَلَّ مِنْكَ مَالًا وَوَلَدًا فَعَسَى رَبِّي أَنْ يُؤْتِيَنِي خَيْرًا مِنْ جَنَّتِكَ. I'm amazed at somebody who wants money, dunya, mal, zinat al-dunya. He wants wealth, he wants this world. I'm amazed that he doesn't come to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. Because I heard straight after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, even if, this is the two brothers, the kafir, the mu'min, the believer, the unbeliever. The believer saying to the unbelieving brother, even if you consider that I have less wealth and I have less children, فَعَسَى رَبِّي أَنْ يُؤْتِيَنِي خَيْرًا مِنْ جَنَّةٍ. Maybe Allah will give me better than your Jannah. All of this wealth, all these gardens, all that you have. فَالْمُؤْمِنِ, the believer, he شَهْرُ الْقُرْآنِ. He doesn't just recite the Qur'an. He doesn't just try and make his voice sound as beautiful as possible, listening to the best sounding one. He doesn't just speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He reads the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he hears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through his words. الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. Give the Qur'an, شهر القرآن, its due right. The due right of the Qur'an is not just to make it sound as nice as possible. It's that you hear with your udhm, with your ears, you hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking to you. And then you've tasted something of tadabbur ma'an al-Qur'an. Then you've tasted something of the reality, the reflection of meanings of the Qur'an. And that's the heart that will never get tired of reading kalam Allah ta'ala. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون. بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم إنه سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين. الحمد لله الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. أما بعد, every one of us in the month of revelation, in the month of Quran, the month of Ramadan, must look at our relationship with the one who sent down the Quran. Look at our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran is hablullah al-mateen. The Quran is the unbreakable rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If our relationship with the Qur'an is broken, then our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is broken. We have nothing without the Qur'an. We have nothing without the one who revealed the Qur'an. We have nothing without the one who receives the Qur'an. And so when we come to the Qur'an, experience Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Experience an-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Experience the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And be like an-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Be like a salaf. السلف الصالح الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين ومن بعدهم. When they would come to an ayah of the Quran and it touched them and it affected them, they wouldn't just read it and move on, because it's not just tilawat of Quran. They would stop and they would repeat and repeat and repeat and repeat the ayah, and it would move their hearts and tears would flow down their eyes. Tardeed ayat al-Quran. They would constantly repeat an ayah of the Qur'an. One night an-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spends the whole night reciting, إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُمْ وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. One night, from Aisha, all the way up until Fajr, Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's reading the same ayah. إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُمْ. If you punish them, they're your slaves. وَإِنْ تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. And if you forgive them, you are the mighty, the wise. The Prophet is so affected by that. He's crying throughout the whole of that night as he's reciting that verse. وَعَنْ تَمِيمِ الدَّارِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ وَأَرْضَاهُ أَنَّهُ كَرَّرَ هَذِي الْآيَةِ أَمْ حَسِبَ الَّذِينَ اجْتَرَحُوا السَّيِّئَاتِ أَنْ نَجْعَلَهُمْ كَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ حَتَّى أَصْبَحَ Tamim al-Dari, Sahabiyun Jaleel. The whole of the night, he just repeats one ayah. Am hasiba الذين اجترحوا السيئات. Do those who commit criminal acts believe that we're going to treat them the same as those who believe and do good deeds? Ubadah ibn Hamza, he said, دخلت على أسماء رضي الله تعالى عنها وهي تقرأ فمن الله علينا ووقانا عذاب السموم فمن الله علينا ووقانا عذاب السموم فوقفت عندها فجعلت تعيدها وتدعو اللهم من علينا من عذاب السموم. سيد أسماء, one of them came to see her, she's in salah, فمن الله علينا, Allah blessed us and he saved us from the poisonous punishment. He said, I stood and I waited, and all she's doing just keeps on repeating and repeating and repeating, and she's making dua. Munna alayna wa waqina adhab as-samum. Bless us and protect us from the poisonous punishment. We have, this is the way the salaf of this ummah. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he comes to the ayah, Rabbi zidni ilma, just keeps on repeating and repeating and repeating. Rabbi zidni ilma. They never saw the Quran as when you start, you have to finish. They saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within the Quran. They saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking to them within the Quran. When they came to an ayah, wastaghfirullah, they would say, astaghfirullah. When they would come to a dua, rabbana, they would say, ameen. They were engaging with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the Quran. Engage with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the month of the Quran. Find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within His book. He revealed Himself through His words for you and I to hear His words in the Quran. And if we do that, we've taken from the month of Ramadan. Otherwise, Taraweeh is just all entertainment. Who's got the nicest voice? It's all just entertainment. It's not meant to be entertainment. It's meant to be engagement with Rabb al-Alameen. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين وصل وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين وصل وسلم على سيدنا محمد حتى ترث الأرض ومن عليها وأنت خير الوارثين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استوي استقيموا تراصوا. Make sure your rows are straight. Stand with shoulders touching. الله أكبر. سبحانك. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله ربنا الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم brothers. جزاكم الله خير. We have collected actually so far 3,500 in cash. And one brother have given a Qard-e Hasana loan as £1,000. So that's £4,500 I have out of the 10,000 target today. So please, like I was saying, those brothers who have joined us later, we are actually in the process of purchasing the Rima's music building, which used to be part of the original masjid. I would like people to give, there were about 2,500 people in this masjid. If everybody was to give £200, we'll get £400,000. We need £500,000 to buy the building. So please, please do your very best. Gather the money within your family. If you can give a loan, we'll be happy to take it as an interest-free loan and we'll pay it back to you as soon as you need it. Please come forward. We, the people of Liverpool, the masjid, the musallis in this masjid, have to buy the building. And then we're going to build a brand new masjid with beautiful facilities for our sisters, for our daughters, for our children, for our boys, for ourselves, as well as a funeral service. So please, please come forward. Jazakumullah khair. I will be waiting for you outside, inshallah, on the front forecourt. Not with the stick, but with a smile, inshallah. Giving a smile is charity. That's all I can give. Inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Please, please take it seriously. Let us collect up to £10,000 today and then inshallah. For iftar, those of you who have joined us first time, iftar is £500 for the night, although it's cost us £1,000. I'm looking at two brothers. If you want to pay individual, it's £5 per person as an iftar. And we do have two Turkish chefs who are cooking for us, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Tonight we have the podcast brothers. The two revert brothers are coming, Ben and Chris, 4:30 till 6. If you want to be in their program, you'll need to go into our Instagram and buy some ticket on the Eventbrite. Tomorrow we have a kids program. I'm sorry, people are praying and I'm talking. Tomorrow we have the kids program from 2 o'clock onwards. So please make sure you bring your children. Let them have fun. In the evening, Sheikh Wadah will teach them how to do prayers, Taraweeh. The children will be leading the Taraweeh under his guidance. So it's a beautiful time to make sure you bring your family and bring some food of your own as well in the iftar. Jazakumullah khair. That's for tomorrow, kids' iftar. Tonight's iftar and every other iftar, the masjid will provide. Like I said yesterday, we will not break the fast here. We'll not have dates or water. We'll go straight into the designated area where we have the iftar and then come back and pray. Please respect the policy of the masjid. Jazakumullah khair.